Ladies and gentlemen, this podcast today is brought to you by our Patreon page. Visit patreon.com/gearnetwork. That's Patreon, patreon.com/GEREnetwork. And look over the memberships to subscribe. For as little as a dollar a month, you could receive this podcast and every other podcast from January 1st of 2020 onward, completely commercial-free, as well as advanced releases of every podcast. If you sign up for as little as $3.50 or more, you not only get that tier, but you also get exclusive podcasts, exclusive content, including the brand new GNE podcast, Gear Network exclusive podcast, starring me, John Cimino, of course. So, again, patreon.com/gearnetwork, completely commercial-free and exclusive content. Do it right now for as little as a dollar a month.
The following is a presentation of the Gear Radio Network.
This is Ray and Bell Share, and you are listening to the All Bets Are Off podcast with that dude, Robbie Vegas. And remember, it's a beautiful day to be a bad motherfucker. Stay tuned, y'all. All bets are off.
Talking about that?
Yeah.
No.
Mom?
It's just out for no reason.
She's got
a blue microphone for no reason.
I'm keeping all of this in.
Good.
We're recording and that's staying in.
It's fine.
So, Rock Soldiers, thank you for being here once again on the All Bets Are Off podcast. I'm the rock star, Robbie Vegas. Today, I'm being joined by The Process. So, introduce yourselves, guys.
How's it going? My name is The Cody Love.
Hello there. I'm TC Cooper.
Together, we are
The Process.
Two of the most handsome guys on the scene right now.
Handsome,
tell you that right now.
Damn right.
I mean, you're a pretty good looker yourself.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
You're good, buddy.
I'm pretty great looking.
You are very great looking. I'm gonna tell you that.
Even though I'm sweating through this shirt.
I could just feel the ratings going up right now. I can feel it.
Feel the ratings and the sweat.
So, before we dig into all this stuff, I do have to tell all you listeners, make sure you check out our sponsor at Unchained Muscle. Unchainedmuscle.uk. Go to the website, get your gym needs. Our Vegas 20 will save you 20% at checkout, and they will donate to mental health charity for your purchase. So make sure you check them out and keep this podcast going. And stick around after the interview. We'll talk about the Nickel City Con guests that are coming through, because you know we're going to be live at the Nickel City Con. So guys, let's dig into this, is what I tried to say.
Word.
You good.
You got it, baby.
Let's go. First question. How did you guys find the Flower City Wrestling Academy?
I got this
one.
Well, we started at the Kayfabe Dojo back in the day, and I found it online, I think, like a few years before we even started. And I was like, yo, Cody, there's a wrestling school in Rochester. Let's go.
So you guys started together, or did you start first?
Together.
We started together.
Oh, okay. Okay. Gotcha.
Because he was just like, hey, you going? I'm going too. I'm like, what? All right, let's do it.
All right, cool. And how long ago was that about?
June 2018.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you guys are so fresh.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I bet it flew by.
It's almost 2 years for us.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's flowing, man.
Well, cool. I'm going to put you guys over real quick before I go on to the next question, because you're honestly better than a lot of people who've been around for 10 years.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it. Yeah.
Myself included. So... So who are your biggest? I'm telling you, man. I'm gonna put you guys over 100 times before we're done with this. So who are your biggest influences and inspirations in the wrestling business?
For mine, like, you mean as in wrestlers themselves?
Yeah.
Mine would be Mick Foley is number one.
Really?
And the guy who made me want to become a wrestler is Sami Zayn.
Oh, excellent. I could see Sami Zayn in you before Mick Foley.
I remember when I got you into wrestling. It was like
Sami Zayn was the first guy.
It was like, I think it was SummerSlam
2016.
Okay. Yeah.
SummerSlam 2016. It was Sami Zayn and Neville.
Oh, nice.
But he wasn't Neville yet. He was Adrian Neville.
That's right.
Versus the Dudley Boys. It was the first match I ever saw. And I saw Sami Zayn came out and I was like, that's my guy.
That's awesome. That's awesome. And that just gives the listeners at home, like, a little bit of gauge on how old you guys are. Yeah. Because most people I have on the show are like, well, I watch Roddy Piper.
Yep.
Well, let me, I won't make you feel old.
Tease the lifelong.
Well, yeah, well, I'll make you feel old. We were born in 1999.
Oh, man.
We're 20 years old,
yeah. Baby.
Wow, I got 12 years on you guys.
Yeah.
I did not know that. Okay,
yeah, we're babies.
He's older than you guys.
Yeah.
That was Cyclone, by the way. He's
Cyclone listening. Jones in the building! That's all I wanted to do.
So, now give us your inspiration.
Well, my brother got me into wrestling when I was like 7, 8 years old.
Okay.
So this is like, what, 2007, something like that? And like the first match I saw was, I always remember this because it was Boogeyman and Kane.
Oh, cool.
Versus William Regal and Dave Taylor.
That's
a strange
match.
Wow. It was such a strange, weird match. But I saw a guy eating worms. I was like, so this is wrestling. This is kind of cool.
And at that moment, you knew.
Yeah.
His career was defined.
Yeah, I was like, all right, wrestling's cool.
Okay, so in that same vein, give me your Mount Rushmores of pro wrestlers.
My Mount Rushmore.
You got to start.
Well, personally, because my guy forever, my inspiration, my number one guy is Kurt Angle.
Awesome.
That's
awesome.
My boy, like, because I was an amateur wrestler back in the day, too, mm-hmm. And I saw him. Well, I saw more TNA Kurt.
Yeah.
Because I was kind of young.
Yeah.
But still, I was like, this is my guy. He's so cool. You know, he was a wrestler, you know, broken freaking neck, everything. And I was like, that's my guy.
Yeah.
I have to put him there for
so that's
me.
That's your number one spot.
That's my number one spot.
Okay.
He would have to be in my Mount Rushmore. But for about, like, four of them?
Yeah.
I'd put Hulk Hogan.
Okay.
Just because
you kind of have to
because he kind of
slyly in the background you have to.
Yeah. Just because like his kind of you could say his impact of like how making it like a business for yourself and like making money.
Yeah.
That's why I put him there. And then third, I'm just a Japanese wrestling mark, so like I put Great Muta there.
Oh, nice. Very cool.
Because that guy is to change the game,
mm-hmm.
like tenfold. Like how long he's been wrestling for? Like
80,000 years.
Still wrestles today.
I didn't see that one coming. I gotta say,
yeah. And then four, I'll put Stone Cold.
Okay,
because it's Stone Cold, baby. Like back that he made wrestling like mainstream and cool. Like everyone loved him. Like he was the guy in like the late 90s or 2000s. Everybody's like Stone Cold Stunner him.
Yeah,
you know, like
giving the
like,
finger at everyone.
Yeah, yeah. Finger like. But now,
you mean the stuff they're still doing now?
They're still doing now, 20 years later, and like nowadays,
that's how we get over, baby.
Like people who don't watch wrestling talk to me and tell me to like RKO people.
Right,
there's people at work, but like back in the day, that was always the Stone Cold Stunner.
Agreed.
And still, I think today it is still.
Okay, that's a good Mount Rushmore right there.
It's probably gonna be Mick Foley, Rowdy Piper, Macho Man Randy Savage. And
Cyclone Joe.
I'm not putting you over, Cyclone.
I'm trying to guess your fourth one in my head right now.
Necro Butcher.
Oh wow! Yep. Did not see that curveball coming. So you like the guys who just break?
I'm
their
a deathmatch guy.
Yeah,
I'm a fan of deathmatch wrestling.
Awesome. Okay, I can kind of see that though because you're willing to do whatever.
Yeah,
I've only been in the ring with you guys as opponents one time and it was in a scramble, so we didn't get to do a whole lot, but
yeah, the mall show.
Yeah, the brawl at the mall.
Brawl at the mall. Yeah.
And I almost broke your back. You remember?
Yep.
And I was like, oh, sorry.
Happens. I forgot the spot. Yeah. Well, I just blew the business. My bad.
Yeah, right. So with you guys being fresh, you got all these different influences, which is impressive, by the way, especially when you said Roddy Piper, because you said the first match you watched was in 2016, right?
Yeah.
So
yeah,
you
still,
say Roddy Piper.
Still
I'm catching
this.
Up.
Yeah. But that blows my mind, though, because you're good at this. So it's not like you've been watching it since birth. Like, you're good at this, but you've been watching it since birth.
Yeah, ever since
I was birthed, I've been watching wrestling.
That's it. Straight out into the Stone Cold onesie.
Straight up. Yeah, the onesie, yeah.
If you do his family, it's like, yeah, it's just like that.
Because, like, gotcha. My family, they're indifferent, I could say, about wrestling. Because
really, it's more your brother.
My brother loves wrestling. He's the one who got me into it. So, okay. I'm like, yeah. But, like, my family, like, my uncle doesn't really like it because I had a distant cousin. He wrestled in the 60s.
Oh, okay.
Out in the old NWA Hollywood.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
But he never won.
Jobber.
He was a job guy.
He's wrestled, like, the biggest names you can think of. Like, he has wrestled, like, Harley Race,
so,
Abdullah the Butcher. Oh, my God. Billy Graham and Freddie Blassie.
Can we, like, start billing you as second generation?
It's not really second, because he was, like, a cousin to me.
Right.
Who was very distant, and he lived in the 60s.
Okay, you know? Gotcha.
And, like, he's buried up in Victor over here.
Okay.
Well, like, it's just weird because I never knew about it until I started wrestling.
Gotcha. So you guys are still fresh. We got into that already. But so far, who are some of your favorite opponents?
Probably Defiance and...
A personal favorite, Matt Lawson.
Defiance, Vile Society. That was fun. Rhythm Booze was really fun.
I really enjoyed when we wrestled Philly and Marino.
Okay.
Philly Marino. Oh, my God. Sorry, guys. Forgot about you.
Yeah. That was one of my favorite matches. It was two matches. It was one of the favorite matches I ever had.
Okay. Very cool. Very cool.
They're cool guys. And
you guys, I feel, and you've already been tag team champions here at Upstate. Which
two times.
And I want to throw that out there because a lot of times when guys are just breaking in, you don't see that for a long time.
No.
So, yeah. I mean, that just goes to show that you guys have come a long way in a short amount of time. And you're putting in the road miles, too.
A lot of grateful. Yeah. I'm so grateful for the opportunities that I've had, and it's just nuts.
Well, you guys are super humble for being as good as you are so quickly. So I got to say thank you for that, because as somebody who's been around for close to 10 years now in this business, you see a lot of young guys break in and are immediate shitheads, especially if they take to it quickly.
It was me for a little bit. We're fixing it.
he's working on
it. We're fixing it. He's getting better.
You admit it. But I always got along with you right from the jump.
Yeah. Like, me and you have always been tight.
I think we've been chill.
The first time I met both of you, I was like, oh, we have a connection.
Because I remember first time we met you, we had our flower gear, and you're like, yo, nice gear. I'm like, thanks, man.
I have my stupid flower pants on.
The flower pants. I got my kisses. Wow on it.
I forgot. I think it was an outdoor show we were doing, and it was your first time. You were both in a battle royal.
Oh my God, we didn't even have those tights yet.
No, it was before those.
Was it before?
We had Zip Ravs tights. Okay. We didn't actually have real gear. We were wearing like yoga pants. Okay.
I do recall
Matic threw me into a wall.
Yes. I recall that too.
I ate the concrete. Cody got destroyed. Fun times.
And they said, welcome to the business, guys.
Yep. Hell yeah.
So let's curve away from wrestling for a minute, because I talked about how we always got along and we have this huge bond over horror movies.
Yes.
So I need to know, where did your love of horror movies start? Like, individually, where did it start?
I always remember just always watching horror movies.
It was just like part of your life.
And, like, I got into, like, just, like, violent video games, I guess you can say. Yeah, right. Like, I just liked this. I was like, yo, this is cool, because, like, I saw, like, Gears of War, and I was like, that's cool, dude, got blown up.
Yeah.
That's sick. I'm, like, what, 7, 8 years old, 6 maybe? I'm like, dude gets destroyed. I'm like, that's kind of cool.
Yeah.
But, like, horror movies have just always been there, I guess.
Okay.
And I just always watched, like, slasher movies, like Friday the 13th, Halloween.
Gotcha.
Always watched those movies when I was younger.
Okay.
It's always been a thing.
I hated horror movies as a kid. And then once I, like, I don't know, balled up and actually, like, watched, I think it was the first horror movie I fully sat, well, first rated R horror movie, quotation marks. It was Van Helsing with
Hugh Jackman?
Hugh Jackman in it.
Okay.
And then there I was like, that's cool. And then once I got...
That was your first one?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And then once I got into heavy metal, it was all downhill from there.
And we're also big metal fans.
And I became...
We're going to talk about that then, too.
Horror movies became more than just, like, a hobby. It's like this weird path. Like, I watched 3 horror movies a night.
Yeah, I'm the same way. That's why... I mean, we bonded because we have that metal music, that horror movie stuff, the wrestling stuff. Yeah. A lot of guys don't have all 3 of those things.
And that's what this podcast revolves around.
Those are our top favorite things talk about or do. Like, wrestling, horror, metal, like, that's our life.
That's it. Yeah. Yeah. And this is, my podcast revolves around those 3 topics. Exactly.
Which is amazing.
You know, having you guys on is
so it's about show. Time, Robbie.
Yeah, I know. How many times have I brought this stuff and I'm like, we're going to do this today.
Yeah, you're
and
like,
then the show ends and I'm like, all right, bye.
Yeah. Like, we're like, I got to get you guys on the podcast. Like, we're even talking to one of the mall shows. Like, I got to get you guys on the podcast. We're like, yes. And,
happens, you know.
Eventually, slowly, we got there. Due to prior booking.
So, favorite slasher flicks, guys.
Slasher?
I'm not just horror. I want to know the slashers.
Nightmare on Elm Street.
I could see that for you.
Done.
I could definitely see that.
Me? Yeah. I grew up on them, so Jason's my guy, so Friday the 13th.
Awesome. Right. We have that in common. Halloween is probably my runner-up, but...
Michael Myers is boring.
Really? I have not heard that said before.
He's the one hater of Michael Myers, which thinks he's boring.
But if you think Mike, okay, here we go.
Rob Zombie fixed him.
Really? Also an unpopular opinion. I will definitely say
the Rob Zombie.
The first movie's garbage.
That movie sucks, but the first one, I actually liked the first one.
First one's good.
The first one I thought was okay, but they lost me during the second.
The second one was trash.
It's bad.
It's like, about his daughter and shit. It was terrible.
What do you guys think about Pinhead?
Okay. Hellraiser's probably number two when it comes to... Because the number one favorite horror movie of all time is Frankenstein 1935.
Oh my god, yeah.
Underneath that is Nightmare on Elm Street, and then probably Hellraiser 1.
Okay.
Love Hellraiser. Big fan of Pinhead. Like, I always thought...
Pinhead... It's just when he face-turned in the second one, it ruined
him. I was so... And then, like, once he face-turned, he got buried.
It ruined him.
He gets buried right away once his face turned. But, like...
Spoiler, by the way. When the movie came out in the fucking
80s. But, yeah. Like, Pinhead was
Can I say the F word? My bad.
Oh, you can swear all you want.
Oh, cool.
Yeah,
yeah. But, like, he was dope. He was just like... You know, the box. Like yo!
You
touch the box. And he has his gang, and just like, yo, what's up?
Now, do you guys both watch the black and white ones? Because you said Frankenstein's your favorite.
Yeah, I've seen just about everything.
Okay.
No, that's his
favorite.
Okay, because that's my favorite stuff. Like, Vincent Price, Boris Karloff, Bela Lugosi.
Yep.
All day. Lon Chaney.
Are you a Hammer horror or Universal horror?
Universal.
Good.
Yes, absolutely. So, with that being said, most underrated horror movie you've ever seen?
That's a hard one.
Right?
Puppet Master.
Okay.
By Full Moon Productions. Because it was the only good movie they ever put out. Besides, like, their joke ones. Because, I mean, they put out Evil Bong.
Yeah.
Like, that's not a movie.
Right. I mean, a good horror comedy goes a long way with me sometimes when I'm feeling funny, but I love horror, so I can't.
Horror comedy's the best. Like, Thanksgiving?
Yep.
That's a good one.
Tucker and Dale versus Evil.
Great one.
But what's your underrated?
My underrated. I wouldn't even know, because I just watched.
Or Hellraiser.
Maybe Hellraiser, yeah.
People hate on it because it's so gory.
A lot of people hate on, especially the original.
And because they compare them to, like, the top guys.
Yeah.
And he puts in that group, so that's kind of unfair, I guess you can say.
I've heard it criticized because there's really no backstory to the first Hellraiser. They just kind of imply things.
They do throw you into it.
And you have to put the pieces together. Yeah. But, I mean...
That's the fun of the movie.
Because, like, me
the
personally...
The movie's about solving a puzzle.
Yeah.
Right.
Because, like, me personally, my favorite... horror genre, it's a psychological horror.
Oh, okay.
That's my favorite genre. Like, that slow burn, like, makes you, like, oh my god.
You really want to figure it out.
Yeah, because, like, The Shining is probably my favorite horror of all time.
Okay.
Like, just that.
Stanley Kubrick Shining, I mean.
Yeah, not the book, the movie. Cause
the miniseries. The miniseries is trash, even though they did it correctly.
Even though Dr. what was it?
Dr. Gave him props and shit on him at Santa.
Yeah, they did it correctly.
Dr. Sleep, I enjoyed that one.
Mm-hmm.
That one was more true to the book.
Gotcha.
But I was more of a fan of The Shining because it's a more of a, like, slow burn.
Because Stanley Kubrick's a fucking genius.
Stanley Cooper, he changed everything. To make it a good horror movie.
And Stephen King hated it. He tortured actresses on set to get the performance.
No, the main lady plays...
His wife.
Jack Torrance's wife. She got, like, abused and, like, screwed up during filming.
I heard it was even traumatic.
We had Chris Caden yelling at me right now.
We're almost there. I swear.
Take this home?
We're wrapping it up right now.
Just started. What you mean, dude?
Dad's yelling at me. Sorry.
Freaking dad.
Wrestled... Am I, like, the big brother or the uncle? I don't even
know.
You're
the creepy uncle.
I'm the creepy uncle.
He's the creepy uncle who gives us cool stuff.
Yeah. I'm like this weird tweener. Like, I'm not that, like, veteran guy, but I'm not the new guy. So it's like, when people start breaking in, they're just kind of like, yeah, we like Robbie. He's, like, the older brother. And I'm like, I still feel old when you guys say that.
That still hurts.
No, he's like, an older brother than me.
Yeah, right. Oof. All right, staying on horror, though. We're not done here.
Yeah, go for it.
The most overrated horror movie you've seen. Everybody praises it. You can't stand it. And mine is It.
Which one?
The original.
Okay, that's fair, because that movie sucks.
It's terrible.
Well...
No, it
sucks. When they're kids, it's good when they're kids.
No, it sucks.
No, it's okay when they're kids because, like, the horror of it is that they're children.
Yeah.
And, like, anything can be scary for them, like, physically.
Mm-hmm.
But when they're adults...
And it becomes a spider.
It's dumb because, like, kids are scared of, like, things like spiders and ghouls and whatever.
And ghouls!
Yeah, ghouls, dude. But, like, adults, they're scared of more, like... subjective things like taxes.
He should have been a taxpayer, man.
Yeah, if he showed up as IRS, he'd be like, oh my god, should have paid your taxes.
I guess I picked a good one then.
Most overrated?
Yeah, like what's something that people like? Because when people find out you guys love horror movies, they probably say, oh, did you see and you guys are like, fuck that movie. Like, there's got to be one of them. Because it happens to me all the time.
It's, for me, most of the time, it's Halloween.
Because you don't like Halloween.
Because I like Halloween, the movie. Halloween Part 1 and 2 are two amazing films.
They're fantastic.
Everything together, else after that sucks. But the character of Michael Myers bores me.
Gotcha. Okay.
You don't like the, what, that his face is like just nothing?
No, he just doesn't do it. Oh, he's just a guy who just walks around stabs
people. The whole point.
Yeah.
That's the whole point. You just hate the point of the movie.
That's the plot.
It's dumb.
That's the plot. It's just like...
Which is stupid because I love Texas Chainsaw and that's literally the exact same process.
Well, Leatherface has more character. Michael Myers is very straight, slow, whatever. Like, Leatherface will get up and run and chase your ass.
And he'll scream.
And scream.
Yeah, yeah.
We're like Michael Myers, like he's motionless.
Walks. Right,
like,
right.
With his Captain Kirk mask.
You can't think of one, can you?
I can't.
That's why I
keep talking. I can't think of one. Well, I love shitty horror movies.
I do too. Straight to DVD, B movies.
Yeah, Hatchet.
Hatchet.
That's it.
Oh, so, wait, I got to plug
Jeepers
my thing.
Or Jeepers Creepers.
Since we're talking about Hatchet, guys, if you're coming to Buffalo for the Nickel City Con, Danielle Harris is doing an appearance there. Check her out. She's from Hatchet, Halloween 4 and 5, and the Rob Zombie remakes. So she's going to be at the Horror Fest on the ground level. Got that plug in there. Here we go.
That's sick plug.
Just happened to go there. You
know? Yeah, that was planned.
Oh, wait. Enrico Browning, who's the original creature from the Black Lagoon. So check that out.
What?
Yeah. And the All Bets Are Off podcast will be there doing a live podcast, and we'll be making our rounds and talking to some people. So come and say hi. So back to you guys.
Awesome. That was a quick plug. I liked it.
Yeah. That was a good one. That worked out. So now give me your Mount Rushmore of horror. Who wants to start?
I'll start. All right. So me, Jason, Michael, because he's kind of, you know, he's the starter.
He's an icon.
He's the icon starter. Freddy,
mm-hmm.
and Leatherface.
Okay.
Those are my four guys, because those are like the...
The most classic.
The most classic, kind of mm-hmm. like, they kind of started the whole trend of slasher and all that.
Agreed. Cody?
Frankenstein, Dracula, Freddy Krueger.
Yeah.
Like, I love them.
You do classic guys.
And Bride of Frankenstein.
Nice. Very cool.
Because she is scarier than Invisible Man and the Mummy.
You guys.
Oh, Wolfman. Wolfman beats her. Sorry.
Oh, Wolfman's great.
Wolfman's got to beat her.
Do you guys watch Abbott and Costello Meet Frankenstein and
yes,
all that stuff?
Those
are the best.
Amazing.
So, do you have, like, a recent horror movie you've seen that you thought was, like, amazing as compared to some of the older ones that we all love?
Well, recently I've been watching real shitty ones, but I really enjoyed, like, Hereditary.
Hereditary is probably the best movie to come out in 2019.
That was super freaky.
That was, because that's that.
Perfect creepy.
Oh, it's
so good.
Did you guys like A Quiet Place?
A Quiet Place was good.
I enjoyed that, but it was distracting because it's Jim.
Yes.
Jim from
The Office.
But really well done.
They did amazing.
They took that silence and really made the best out of it. To the point where when they showed running water, I jumped just because there was sound.
Yes.
Yeah.
They made silence in 2019 work. Because mm-hmm. that's something most directors and actors struggle with. Because
it's tough.
Everybody wants... Nobody has the attention span.
No. Not at all.
So that made me happy because half the movie is silence.
Yeah.
And
I actually watched it without the subtitles for all the sign language.
Oh, yeah.
So I had even nothing to read. I just watched it in silence and was piecing it together.
Yeah.
And so whenever something would happen, any kind of noise, I'd jump.
Yeah.
And I don't jump at horror movies. So I was
You
know? But any other ones that come to mind besides those two? You probably watch them all the time.
So yeah,
we just watch.
Sorry, what was the question? I just forgot it.
The best recent horror movie.
Best recent, I would say Cabin in the Woods.
Okay.
Big fan of Cabin in the Woods. That's a good one.
If you want a super recent one, I really like the Netflix original Into the Grass.
Oh, Into the Tall Grass.
Into the Tall Grass.
I just watched that too.
That was interesting.
Mm-hmm. That was different.
It was messing with my head.
Yeah, it was weird.
I couldn't follow at
it
one
was
point.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was good.
So.
It's a good... What the fuck is going on?
Right. You don't know what is happening in the entire movie.
I agree.
It's like, what?
I kind of still didn't know when it ended.
Even when it ended, I had to really think about it. It's like, what?
Oh, Oculus. Right.
Oh, that was good.
There's one that you could throw on the underrated category.
Oculus, I agree.
Because that is, it's about a killer mirror.
Yeah,
and a lot of people
wouldn't watch it because it was a WWE film.
No, I watched it because it was like, oh, everybody's trying to make a horror film? Let's see how this is.
I didn't know it was a WWE film.
No? It was okay.
Until literally right now.
I thought it was good.
Really? You did not know? Yeah, it was WWE right studio
yeah.
film
WWE studios, yeah.
that made
Why?
It.
Why?
They were going through that phase where they did the See No Evil movies. They did that.
Well, who was in that movie?
No wrestlers.
No wrestlers.
They're going through phases where they like, there was a phase in WWE where they tried to make movies.
Yeah.
without the wrestlers.
Yeah, because there was Leprechaun and Hornswoggle in it, but he was dressed up in terribleness.
Of course. Leprechaun may be overrated and underrated at the same time, because some of those movies were really good and some of them were really bad.
Lep in the Hood. Lep in the Hood is all you need.
Or in space.
Leprechaun in space is my favorite. Nothing beats Jason X.
Jason X is the best space horror movie.
Listen, I don't care who you are. If you don't watch that just because it's fun, and you take it seriously and you're like, I can't believe that. It was just fun, people. It was just Jason doing something different.
Remember, hockey's going to be outlawed in like 4 years. Yeah.
The only thing you can get mad at is when remakes fuck up. Because in 2009, Friday the 13th sucked. And don't even get me started on Nightmare on Elm Street 2010. Because we'll be here for a while. And it'll be a lot of cussing.
Here's an unpopular opinion. I liked the Friday the 13th remake.
I don't like you.
You were
awesome.
I didn't love it. But I was like, you know, they did a decent job of combining three movies into one movie.
Yeah.
And because that's difficult. You took three movies that would total like 6 hours and made it one movie. That was pretty cool. But it'll never beat the originals. Nightmare on Elm Street, however, was fucking terrible. And I put it off because I was like, you're going to ruin Freddy. I refuse to watch it. Like, Jason doesn't talk. How bad can you ruin Jason?
Yeah.
But Freddy is a very vocal character.
Yeah, they
I watched it
serious.
For the first time 2 weeks ago. I shit you not. Yeah. Because I would not watch it. I put it on, and by the time it was over, I was like, bullshit. I was heated all over again, and it's 10 years old.
It's really bad.
It is. Like, they changed the backstory.
They did the same thing in Friday the 13th remake, and it made me mad.
That's true. So how does metal music fit in with your love of horror? Did you guys check out Wednesday 13, by the way?
I did.
What'd you think?
They're pretty good. I'm still a big Ice Nine Kills fan.
Oh, that Silver Screams.
Yeah.
I think that's... I love that album.
Yeah.
Because it's just like... album is amazing.
I know a friend of mine was like, because Code Orange made a new album, and he was saying it was like very horror-esque, so I got to listen to that.
Yeah. So are you guys like Rob Zombie, like all that stuff? Is it just metal in general?
Mixture. I think recently you like more screechy.
I'm into punk rock right now.
Okay.
Super. Like Sex Pistols.
That kind of punk rock.
Old
the good stuff.
Punk, yeah, old
stuff that made it cool.
Yeah, right.
Classic punk. And then I'm also just into... I'm into all sorts... Every genre of metal that you can think of.
I'm into
the whiny, girly shit to...
Listen, I think in metal
Death
stuff...
Deathcore shit.
In metal stuff, sometimes when a chick is singing or whatever, I think it sounds a little bit better.
Yeah. So, like, Walls of Jericho and stuff like that?
Yeah, that stuff. It just sounds... I don't know what about it, but, like, chick singing metal...
It's very different.
It's different, and just, like, I don't know what's, like, satisfying or soothing. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Sexually.
Sexually.
It does something to
you. Yeah, baby, but... No, just something about it. Like,
we're
it's
pigs.
Like,
oh, my God.
But, like,
I
think
didn't
about,
say anything. I'm just sitting here.
That's the thing, like, when, like, wrestlers have, like, chick singing themes, it's, like, sounds like they're, like, ballers. Like,
yeah.
They got, like, Christian's old theme, which is way better than whatever.
Oh, my God, yeah.
And it just sounds better. Mm-hmm. I don't know about it.
No, I agree. I think women metal singers in the industry right now have more of a grasp on what's going on. Like, bands like New Year's Day and In This Moment, and you hear those bands, you immediately like them. I don't know what it is. I think it's just because, like, the vocals stand out more. You can hear more of what they're saying. Like, Ash Costello does Rhea Ripley's music.
Yeah.
You know, and it's just insane how popular that... I don't want to call it its own genre because that's kind of weird, but women in metal are really, like, taking over.
It's not its own genre, but it kind of became one.
It shouldn't be a genre.
No.
It should just be metal. But, like...
And it is, but it's not, because it is different.
Yeah.
You know, but...
It's different enough to be kind of its own thing.
Yeah. It almost makes it not as heavy. Like, it's a blistering guitar, and you're like, holy crap. And then you hear the vocals, and it brings it down just enough to where you're like, I could just rock out
to this. You
can
just vibe to
it, too. Even, like, some of the more older ones, like Flyleaf, like... Because they're not even necessarily heavy metal, but, like...
They were that new metal stuff.
They were the start of, like... Those were the... Like, Flyleaf, Paramore... Like the first couple of women vocalists that I've heard, and I remember like Haley, she's just come on.
I agree.
Cold Orange is the same as that one chick that sings for them, and they're heavy as shit.
So, who would you guys say are your favorite metal bands?
Well,
is that a tough one?
That'd be a tough one, but like not by order, but I have to put Metallica in there.
Yeah,
because I grew up on that shit.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a big fan of Trivium.
I love Trivium.
Yeah. And I'm super excited for the new album.
Yeah.
Have you heard Catastrophist?
Yes.
Yeah, six and a half minute long.
Oh,
kind of brings back kind of that old school vibe to it.
And so really good live, by the way. So good live.
You know, as a metal fan, I really haven't been to a lot of concerts either.
Oh, okay.
I've been to a Mastodon concert.
Mm-hmm.
And me and Cody went to the Warp Tour, the 2018, whatever, last year, whatever the hell it was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I would say probably Ice Nine Kills, obviously. Slipknot, just, yeah.
I love, I'm a huge Corey Taylor fan.
Yeah,
okay.
Except for, I'm not a fan of Stone Sour, though.
No?
No. It's just, too
different. He's different.
It's, just, it's too different. Corey. It's not Corey. I heard he's trying to do his own project now.
I've heard that too, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's not very good.
we'll see. We'll see what happens.
And a third would have to be either, probably Disturbed.
Okay. Very cool.
Probably Disturbed.
Now, old Disturbed.
Yeah.
or Avenged Sevenfold.
Do you think that they're... Avenged, yeah. Yeah, I could see that.
Not their new stuff, though. I can't dig into their new stuff.
Well, somebody creeping in on us right now? Yeah. Oh, look. It's Anthony Gaines. None of a kind.
It's none of a kind Anthony Gaines.
Wow.
So let's bring it back to wrestling. If you guys want to bring me back to, like, your goals in wrestling, like, give me some stuff that's on your bucket list.
Make it in a big company. I'm
sorry, did you say naked in a big company? Make it in a big company.
Make it in a big company. I don't know.
I don't know about make it, but naked, but yeah, I'll do that.
I don't know. That's a hard question to answer.
Especially when you're fresh. That's why I asked it. So, when you're naked and fresh.
I don't know.
You're nice, nice and fresh, baby.
We just scared Gaines away. But just in general, like, well, here's how we'll do this. So who are some of your dream opponents in either a tag team match with both of you or separately in singles?
So I want to wrestle Marty Scurll.
Okay.
Because I love his style of wrestling. Because he does a mixture of just everything that I like in wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just like, what he does, I'm a big fan of it. And it's like, it's simple, but yet creative to a way it's different.
Gotcha.
To what his whole thing that he does. And
so you see yourself kind of meshing well with that.
I love British style. And like, I like British style and Japanese style the most. Like, I like that strong style stuff. But I also like the, come on, wrestle.
Yeah,
fan of the I watch tape of like old Giant Saint stuff just to see how he like moves joints. Like that because I had my background in amateur wrestling, so I already have that grapple stuff.
So you like guys like Pete Dunne?
Yeah, I'm a fan of Pete. Yeah. I like Pete. Pete does good stuff.
I could see you being in there with him then.
I'm Pete Dunne.
Yeah, I'll Pete Dunne. I'll beat people up. I'll hurt people.
I love it.
Yeah.
So that now, what about for a tag team?
Tag team.
Yeah,
dude.
All time or just current?
Whoever you'd like to face at any point in time. Take it to dream matches, man. Like, who's somebody you guys think that you could mesh with?
Fucking Rockers.
I knew you were going to say that. I knew it. Rockers, as soon as I said
Rockers.
It all the time.
If you say Rockers, then, of course, Bucks. But, you know,
yeah.
people call us Young Bucks for some reason.
We got to wrestle the Bucks.
Because everyone calls us it because we have colorful pants.
I guarantee you guys will wrestle the Young Bucks sometime because you're just breaking in and you're already good. It'll happen.
Holy crap, thank you.
It'll happen, trust me.
That'd be crazy.
Cody, you got to give me a singles one, too.
I gotta think.
I love the wrestle that those guys. All those.
It would
guys
probably be like a dream match for me. Would be Jimmy Havoc.
Okay.
Because
okay.
I'm just a huge mark for that dude.
I'll throw in another one. Kenta.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Because Kenta's.
He was like my first. Because when I first got into like indie
or
wrestling,
Sami Zayn,
Sami
Zayn. Yeah.
Yeah, because I got into like Ring of Honor wrestling.
Yeah.
And that stuff. Like, pretty soon, I guess. Like, I watched for a while for wrestling, and then I stopped watching completely.
Okay.
And it was, like, 2010, 11, like, Capital Punishment era.
Yeah.
And I just completely hated wrestling.
Okay.
And then,
why? Just...
It sucked.
Okay.
It was just boring.
So, basically, it just wasn't holding your attention.
It wasn't holding my attention. It sucked. It was terrible. And then, literally, then one day, my brother was like, hey, check this out. He showed me CM Punk's pipe bomb. I was like, that's cool.
And it brought you
back. He brought me back to wrestling. Cool. And then after that, I started finding other things other than WWE. And I was like, this is cool.
Do you guys both, like, study all wrestling? Or do you just, like, you have your favorite stuff, you have your favorite stuff? Or what is it?
I try to study it. All types of wrestling, Cam. Yeah. Just to see, I like to.
Is it like the same, or is this you guys
dude
have separate?
This dude goes hard.
No,
Troy goes hard. Is
yeah,
what you're saying?
Yeah.
Like I try to go hard, but he's this kid's insane.
This is all I do. If I have free time, I watch tape, or like I'll find like random seminars online.
So how does this tag team mesh so well? Is it just because you guys are
well,
friends before
yeah, he's
wrestling?
He's got a really strong back.
My back is real. I'm glad I lift weights because I got carry.
But no. Do you guys just know each other at this point?
We've known each other since preschool. Like,
and so. Do you find yourself barely having to communicate in the ring? Or is it still... How does that...
Yell at each other.
I'm not asking you to fully pull back the curtain, but just a little glimpse. Like, how does that work?
So we usually, if we look at each other, we kind of know what we're thinking. Because we've known each other for so goddamn long. We've known each other since we were 3 years old. We met at preschool.
Mm-hmm. I didn't know that.
Wow. Yeah.
Well, that explains everything.
Yeah. So, yeah.
That's why we're the world's most bestest friends.
Yeah, because we've known each other longer than everyone.
So it's not a gimmick.
It's real life, damn it.
It's still real to me, damn it.
Okay, cool. So tonight, we're here, UPW March Meltdown.
Yeah,
we're live. What are you guys feeling about your match tonight? This is going to be my last question before I let you
plug your shit. So we got a lot of people in that match. Yeah. We got the entire majority of the tag team division.
Right.
Listen.
Right.
I'm excited.
We are excited because we kind of been having we're in a little stump lately, and... We got to climb back up.
We got to prove.
Got
all right?
Got you.
We got to show who we are.
Yeah.
All right?
Back to the top of the UPW Tag Team Division.
Where you belong.
We belong.
Went from two-time tag champs to get beat up by my trainer, and I'm not happy about it.
By dad.
Yeah. Our own Russell father beats us up daily.
I'm going on record right now. I want to face you each one-on-one, but I would also like the Nightbreed to face the process sometime. Oh. I won't say where on the show because it might not happen, but I already pitched this idea somewhere else, so we'll see what happens with that.
I would love to.
Love to.
But let's...
Wherever you can get us booked.
Hey, yeah. Book us.
Book me.
Hey.
Buy my shirt.
Buy our merch.
I mean, that leads me into my final question. Why don't you guys plug all your upcoming events and all your social media where promoters can reach you? Because I will vouch for these guys any day of the week. If you have a tag team division and they are not a part of it, your tag team division is not what it can be. So get these guys on your show. Wow. I promise you we'll take a step up.
Thank you, man. I really appreciate it.
Rob.
Dude, I'm telling you. Everywhere
I
go.
Our expectations too high.
Yeah. No way. No way. You guys got this. Every time I watch you guys, I'm like, they just got better again. So plug all your stuff, your individual social medias, like shows, whatever you got.
My Twitter and Instagram is at UncannyTC. So you can check me out there. I post everything that's going on, or processes at, where I'm at. Just updated stuff.
We got me. I'm the Cody Love on Instagram. I would say use that one because that's the one I use. On Twitter, it's Cody Love TTP.
Getting better at Twitter. All right, it's a working it's a process.
I don't use Twitter. I think it's a dumb way, but it's cool.
It's a tool, but you know.
You could also reach us for booking stuff on Facebook. Just Nicholas Falconer.
There, you can DM.
I don't know who that is. He's probably your agent.
Yeah, he's my agent. Okay. You'll see him. Just look that up. You'll find him.
Yeah, he's around.
He's always hanging around looking for autographs and shit.
Yeah.
I hate that kid.
You should probably put him in check.
Yeah.
Well, guys, I seriously appreciate having you on.
We love being on.
Yeah, thank you for having us, man.
If you got more events that you want to talk about before we end this thing, feel free. But if not, I'm just going to say
besides Spring Loaded, I don't really know what else to promote.
I don't know this month at all, actually.
It's a weird time right now for wrestlers.
Yeah, because everything's getting canceled, so there's not a lot of shows happening lately. Yeah.
So we'll say this. We'll keep you guys up to date, and when we have more, we will give you more. So
we will let
you check out Upstate Pro Wrestling. Buy our merch, because we need to get rid of it.
Yeah, we need gas money.
These guys are still working for hot dogs and handshakes, people. Like, buy a damn t-shirt.
I'm still living with our parents.
I saw him sleeping out behind the venue today. So, you know, make sure you buy a shirt and make sure that they could eat.
Hell yeah.
So thank you for joining us on another episode of All Bets Are Off.
Hell yeah.
Always thank you, and always trust the process.
The preceding presentation has been brought to you by the Gear Network.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
You know, I'm often asked about the logos of the show and Gear Network and everything. It comes to me, JC, where do you get the designs, the cool designs for the show and everything? And I want to tell you, I'm going to tell everybody right now, right here, you heard it here, it is IndyCard Media. IndyCard Media is a local business that specializes in making quality designs for your website or your business. Whatever you do, they can do it. If you need proof, you can look at all of our logos, or you can go to facebook.com/IndyCard Media to see all of the designs, which include a political banner, because they've done political banners, and I mean everything. Nothing is off limits with them. Give Eric a shout at IndyCardMafia@gmail.com, and he will help you bring your design to life. Tell him Gear Network sent you, and hey, he may hook you up with a little something-something, or at least a smile, because you heard it here. But go to IndyCard Media Facebook. Again, facebook.com/IndyCard Media. Do it now. Bring your designs to life.